What happened to all the videos? Why aren't we seeing any new videos lately? Welcome back, digital watch fans, to Vintage Digital Watches. And yes, you're right, there has been a lack of videos on the channel, but that's because I had a few changes in my life that made time really scarce for me. But we will pick it up, and I have the end of year pickups, so those are the pickups for the last 6 months. That will be a super interesting video. I've got tons of watches to show you. I've got the watch room tour that I'm doing at the end of the year. You'll see how my watches look on the shelves, a few close-ups, because you usually get to see them from afar. And I have another few items here, and I plan to do a bit of decoration, and I have a few other technical videos in between. But that's enough talking about the future. Let's talk about today's video. Today's video is going to be the most non-typical video that you've seen thus far on the channel, and that's because we are traveling way back in the past. And what I mean by that is we are going to look at four videos that were done smack dab in the middle of the 80s, and the subject of the videos are the Seiko RC and UC Computer watches. So that's something that I've been talking about lately on the channel, and why not talk even further? So these four videos, there will be two videos that are two tech shows from two TV tech shows from the 80s that are talking about the watch, so they will be showcasing them. And there are two further showcase video that are done by Seiko, which were supposed to be as commercials. Now, these aren't on YouTube or anywhere else from what I've seen. So if you love grainy 1980s video with synthesizer music, funky playing in the background, these are the videos for you. So let's roll the tape.
Well, I reckon the first prize for innovation here at the show goes to Seiko, the Japanese watch people, for the introduction of this thing, the RC1000, which basically is a quartz multifunction computer terminal that you wear on your wrist, and it can hold a great deal of information. For instance, this one's got on it a reminder of an anniversary, a squash booking, meet the girlfriend, a reminder of an award ceremony coming up, all kinds of other good things. You download the information from a range of computers, ranging from the BBC Micro, the Epson, the Apple II, right down to the Sinclair Spectrum, through this little gizmo here, which connects up to the RS232 port, and you just put it straight into the wrist terminal. And what have you got when you've done it? Well, you have got a glamorous executive toy, that's true, but it has some real uses as well. Consider, for instance, if you were a travelling salesman handling a range of products, all with differing prices. Well, what better way than to keep that price list here on the wrist, so you can conclude the deal with the client there and then. What's more, you could even download that price list online into your own computer at home and then onto the wrist terminal. Or look at it another way. Supposing you were unfortunate enough to have to take various medications, lots of pills at lots of different times. Well, you can remind yourself when to take them here on the watch. It's also got an alarm facility to remind you of really important things, like watching database, and I am assured it does tell you the time. But I haven't discovered how that works. Anyway, there we are, the RC1000 wrist terminal. Quite a thing. As Jane said, this is the last in the present series of database. We hope to be back with you very soon. We hope you've enjoyed this trip to the Personal Computer World Show. But now, let's use the terminal to run the end credits.
Computer terminal. And what makes this watch a real computer terminal, not just a watch with a memory store, is that inside it's got the components that allow computers to receive, modify, and pass information onto each other. All miniaturized, of course. Now, as you can see, I've downloaded my script onto my watch from the main Tomorrow's World computer via this. It's a two-way adapter. But I can do more than that. If I take off my watch, link it up to this little device, I can also link into Howard's small watch terminal. Now, are we ready to go?
Yes.
Data in, press the button, and in 10 seconds, that data should have passed from mine to yours.
And then I'll be able to continue with the item.
I do hope so.
Let's see. Oh, there we are. Great. Well, you can have that bit of the machinery, and I'll just press this, and this. No, it doesn't want to change. Coming up soon, it says. Ah. Oh, all right.
Well, anyway, it's now got my script on it. But the memory on these time terminals isn't actually very good. It's quite limited, in fact. So it's mainly used for diaries and addresses or price lists and sale figures. But you can change the information here on the watch, and that could be especially useful for anyone who's away from the office or the home. And I can show you that because there is a mistake on the... There it says Northwest Mexican, and it should be, I know it should be, New Mexican. So if I put the cursor in there and then spin it through, we should get New. There we are. New Mexican. All right, now, if I'm in Berlin, Budapest, or even Blackburn, I can ring the changes down, any standard acoustic coupler like that, and that will change the main computer at base. Now, I happen to know that dinosaurs are in New Mexico, because I was there at the time.
Wrist terminal, Seiko RC 1000. From your personal computer to your programmable wristwatch, information at the touch of a button. By programming data from your personal computer, the Seiko RC 1000 turns your wristwatch into a walking memo bank and scheduler that stores a wide variety of appointments and information. RC 1000 functions. In addition to providing a lucid time display readout, the RC 1000 is a handy memo bank for telephone numbers, client lists, appointments, weekly schedules, and a wide variety of other information. Its schedule alarm function lets you arrange your appointments to the exact month, day, hour, and minute. Its weekly alarm function allows you to program weekly activities to the exact day, hour, and minute. The RC1000 will beep every week when the reminder time for your scheduled appointment arrives. And its world time function is also very handy, letting you know the exact time for the various locations you have programmed in memory. The RC1000 allows you to store these four different kinds of information up to a total of 80 items. Each item displays information in up to 24 characters. How to display the data. Now, let's see how the RC1000 displays information in its programmable terminal mode. The RC1000's programmable memory recalls up to 80 data items. Data is stored under labels, which are handy for creating and reviewing the different data categories. To review data in the telephone number list, for example, first press the terminal button. The RC1000 switches from the time display to the memo display mode, and the first label appears in the LCD display. Continue pressing the terminal button until the desired label appears in the display. Now press either the set or select button. The display will move to the first item in that category. From then on, press either the select button to move down the display list or the set button to move up the list. In this manner, the RC1000 serves as your own personal wrist notebook. Its memo function lets you program and display virtually all types of data in blocks up to 24 characters. With its schedule alarm function, you can program appointment times freely. When the scheduled time arrives, the alarm beeps and the message is displayed until the beep stops. Along with displaying the scheduled time in days, a.m. or p.m. hours and minutes, the schedule alarm function reminds you of the scheduled activities in a message of up to 12 characters. The weekly alarm function reminds you of scheduled weekly activities at the same time every week. When the time for the scheduled activities arrives, your RC1000 beeps and displays the appointment time along with the reminder message in up to 12 characters. As with the items in the memo function, items on your weekly alarm list and schedule alarm list can also be reviewed using the select and set buttons. The world time function displays the time for different regions of the world on the LCD display. In addition to the hour, a.m. or p.m., the minutes and seconds are displayed along with the name of the city or country in up to 12 characters. Times in the world time memory can be displayed using the select and set buttons. How to program your watch. Now, let's briefly explain how to program your RC1000 with your personal computer. Your RC1000 comes with special software for programming your watch. The software is available for the IBM PC, Apple II, Commodore 64, and other popular personal computers. Using this data input software is very easy. The software is made to be menu-driven, so you can operate the software by just following the instructions displayed on the screen. If you wish to input data for your RC1000's memo function, such as telephone numbers, for example, key in the input label like this. And below the label line, input your telephone number data. Data for other functions, such as the schedule and weekly alarms, can be input in the same manner. The time difference data file, which is memorized in the software, also makes it easy to program the world time function. Data that is programmed into the RC1000 can also be stored on floppy diskettes to be updated, altered, or printed out later as desired. how to transmit data to the RC 1000. To transmit the data from your computer, connect the RC 1000 with a special cable which also comes with your watch. Different cables are available depending on the type of computer you're using, such as IBM PC or Apple II, Commodore 64, and other computers. Match up the arrows on the RC 1000 and the connector, and fit the connector to the left side of the watch. Then press the other side in place with your hand. First, set your computer ready to send data to your RC 1000. Then, place your watch in the data input mode, press the terminal and lock buttons in sequence. Press the return key of your computer and the data transmission will begin. Once all the data has been transferred into the RC 1000's memory, the watch will make a single beep and return to the display mode to display the first label. This truly handy and functional walk-around timepiece is a memo holder and scheduler that today's busy person will find extremely useful. As well as being a great business aid, the RC 1000's versatility will be appreciated by people from all walks of life. Seiko Memo Diary. The Seiko Memo Diary UC3000 is a miniature digital notebook. With the combination of the wrist module and special keyboard, you can easily input memos of up to 1,000 characters, in addition to a 31-day schedule. The Seiko Memo Diary. Two main features. The memo function. You can input 100 lines of 10 characters each for a total of 1,000 characters. 40 characters can be displayed on the LCD screen at any one time. The scheduler function. This lets you input your schedule for 31 days. Each schedule entry consists of the date, day, and time, as well as a 20-character message. If you like, an alarm will sound at your designated time, and the message will be displayed to remind you of your scheduled appointments and activities. You can input up to 15 entries for one day, and you can enter a total of 43 scheduled items up to a month in advance. How to input your memos and schedules. Inputting your schedules and memos is very easy. First, place the wrist module on the transmission circuit of the keyboard unit and press it down lightly until you hear a distinct click. Then press the transmit button on the wrist module and turn the keyboard's power switch on. If you want to enter memo information, select the memo input mode by pressing the memo key, and then press the cursor down key. Now you are ready to input your memo items. Any type of information, such as telephone numbers, flight schedules, etc., can be entered up to a total of 1,000 characters. Entering your schedule is also very easy. Press the schedule key to select the schedule input mode. First, input the date of your scheduled item. After you input the date, be sure to press the Enter key. If you want an alarm beep to remind you of your activities or appointments at the scheduled time, enter this bell mark in front of the scheduled time entry. Next, enter the time. Then, enter your scheduled activities in a message of up to 20 characters. Utilizing special characters, you can shorten your message and thus input quite a lot of information. For example, this telephone mark can be used to remind you to make a phone call. You can use these editing keys for correction at any stage during input. There's no need to worry, even if you make a mistake during data entry. Practical editing keys of delete and insert let you correct input errors easily. How to look up your data entries. When you want to look up your memo entries or schedules, use the mode button to select the required mode. Pressing the Set button will then display the first group of data, and then you can scroll up or down through the data to your desired entry by using either the Set or Select buttons. The Seiko Memo Diary UC3000 is an additional secretary for the businessman on the move. By wearing the wrist module and carrying the keyboard in your pocket, all the information you need during your busy day is available at your fingertips. For a busy businessman like you, the Seiko Memo Diary is just what you need to plan your days.
What a trip, right? Thanks for watching the video, and do stay tuned because the next video will be about the LCD screen burn. So you know, some watches, they have that rainbowy effect in the middle of the screen that looks like a screen burn. So we are going to take a look if that is even fixable. Give this video a thumbs up and do hit the subscribe button so you'll be notified when I release a new video. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye.